Do you hear that? Yeah, so that is the deafening silence of so-called free speech advocacy groups that are keeping mum while medical groups lobby Attorney General Merrick Garland to go after reporters who are exposing children's hospitals that provide this questionable treatment, these sex changes, on children. So just to kind of bring everybody up to speed here, the American Academy of Pediatrics, the American Medical Association, and the Children's Hospital Association, they sent a letter to Merrick Garland demanding that he investigate and prosecute journalists and activists who are shedding light on the irreversible so-called gender-affirming treatments being done on children. So in other words, the left wants the Department of Justice to go after journalists who shed light on these surgeries that are being done to children who have such impressionable and malleable minds. But nowhere to be found are these free speech organizations that, remember, were so gung-ho to go after Donald Trump, and now, when it comes to children's welfare, their health, they're nowhere to be found. Remember when Trump threatened to revise libel laws and the ACLU said that Trump's threat was not credible and that Trump had made it very clear that he doesn't stand for freedom of the press? Then you had the National Coalition Against Censorship, whose stated mission is to literally protect freedom of speech, criticizing Trump for trying to intimidate the media. And naturally, both the ACLU and the National Coalition Against Censorship, they have refused multiple comment requests from the Daily Caller to comment about the demanded censorship of conservative journalists and activists. Again, crickets. Crickets at a crisis point like this. And the best part about this is that a lot of the reporting, basically all of this information was public, right? It's on their websites, it's on their YouTube pages, and granted, I mean, they were talking to a very cloistered audience and most of their YouTube videos have under 500 views. But what does this tell you? This tells you that, first of all, they did not expect the public to see this. Second of all, they did not expect that if the public saw this, there would be such an intense backlash and interest in child welfare. And these organizations were wrong, right? These hospitals were wrong, as it turns out. The public does, in a very bipartisan fashion, take interest in child welfare, okay? And here's the thing, these organizations and hospitals, they were perfectly content to keep all this content up on their sites, on their YouTube pages, because at the time, they thought that the only people reading it would be these confused children and far-left gender activist groups, right? But the moment the story broke among a general audience, there was massive outrage and backlash, and rightfully so. So, naturally, that means these hospitals and medical centers that have been exposed for these types of surgeries are now trying to simply sweep it under the rug, right? So, take a look at Vanderbilt University Medical Center. They had a trans clinic which provided trans buddies for children who attended appointments, and they also were monitoring doctors who misgendered patients. Well, after backlash, they simply just wiped the trans clinic right off their website. If you have nothing to hide, if this is all being done in good faith and good moral standing, why go on a cleaning frenzy? Then you had a video coming out of Boston Children's Hospital, which was promoting gender-affirming hysterectomies. And after a ton of backlash, the video was pulled. The site also said that they were offering a bunch of, you know, gender-bending surgeries to children as young as 17. But after more backlash, they ended up saying it was to patients 18 and older. In another case, you had the Children's National Hospital in Washington, D.C., claiming it would provide a hysterectomy for a 16-year-old. And then, after a report came out exposing this, the hospital scrubbed it from its webpage, and they later told the Daily Caller that the webpage was just poorly designed and that's not what they actually meant, so they changed it to protect their staff. Why delete all of this content if you stand behind what you're doing? Why change the age range for these questionable surgeries? Why nuke all of your YouTube videos explaining how much money you can make, right? Why take down videos explaining how chemical castration is actually good for children? And again, we do not condone any kind of violence or threats. On the other hand, powerful public institutions that fail to serve the common good, who fail to uphold shared values around child welfare, right? Which, again, the entire public has a stake in how well our children grow up and how they function in society. They are undoubtedly going to receive backlash, and rightfully so, okay? And the truth is that these treatments that these children are undergoing, you know, young children, they are highly questionable, right? The move to squash dissent comes with a bunch of censorship vocabulary, right? You hear disinformation, harm and violent rhetoric, and it's pure gaslighting. That's what it is. They're trying to convince you that you having a problem, that you taking umbrage with a child having their reproductive parts snipped off means that you're the problem. They claim that these treatments are evidence-based, and yet we see major hospitals in countries like the UK, Finland, Sweden, they have actually recommended discontinuing so many of these services because there's been such an increase in children claiming that they're trans. This is not settled debate by any means, okay? And they have interest in crushing dissent, these liberal institutions, because they're making money off of it. They are making money, and they're doing it on the backs of a child's physical and mental health to try to push their gender-bending, woke, far-left, radical agenda about gender. We need more debate, not less, okay? And especially when the subject regards a child's welfare, it is contentious. The public should have the freedom to debate vigorously on these types of issues. Freedom of speech is the cornerstone of the foundation of this nation. And when freedom of speech could be the difference between a child cutting off their reproductive parts or a child getting the actual care and mental health that they need, well then, have at it.